الله Almighty says in the Holy Quran, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوءِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُم مُّصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. He also says, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. These verses and other references would like to say that test is a permanent divine tradition. Life is a long series of tests for every servant of God. We are all on the measured mile, whether we realize it or not. The manner in which we respond to tests determines the place we occupy in the kingdom of God. Severe testing is not the mark of divine disapproval, rather the reverse. Only ore which bears precious metal is subject to crushing and processing. Only the alloy in which there's valuable metal is placed in the refiner's crucible. Since God has pledged himself never to test his servants beyond their ability to bear, a severe test is in reality his vote of confidence. Look to the life of the prophets. In Abraham's life, the tests were progressive in both depth and intensity. In the case of Job, there's no element of choice. They came in crushing waves.